A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 8th November, on the front page you have 4,000 security forces sent to Ayodhya. So Ministry of Home Affairs has sent advisory to all states to maintain law and order ahead of Supreme Court verdict, and even in Ayodhya, security forces are in place now. And here you can see it is a tiger which is seen trapped between rocks in Sirna River in Chandrapur district of Maharashtra. It is said the animal is said to have sustained spinal injuries after it jumped 35 feet off a bridge into the river. It is said the tiger died as such thing. Then below you have allow UN observers into Kashmir. So Finnish minister says that members of European Parliament team that visited Srinagar lacked expertise. So let UN observers visit Kashmir. And here you have RBI to probe IDBI breach of client privacy. So RBI is probing a suspected breach of client confidentiality by IDBI bank. The allegation is that the bank gave access to its client data to Life Insurance Corporation of India, LIC, which owns 51% stake in the bank. On page 8 you have Chennai can bank on AP for water. So this is regarding Nellore Reservoir. So it has good storage, and Chennai city, which is grappling with severe water drinking water shortage, it is said can be assured of its fall quota of Krishna water from Andhra Pradesh this season. So major reservoirs in Nellore district have comfortable storage. So this is what has been asserted as such now. So it is Kandaleru Reservoir, which augments drinking water supply to metropoles, Chennai, has built up a healthy storage of over 40.82 TMC feet water, with the Krishna River in spate in several spells. Then on page 9 you have Maharashtra tops in justice delivery. So this is a report which has shown that Maharashtra has topped the list of 18 large medium states in the overall first ever ranking of Indian states on justice delivery. So Maharashtra is followed by Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Punjab and Haryana. So this is India Justice Report 2019, which has been released by Tata Trust in collaboration with Center for Social and Commonwealth Human Rights. So Center for Social Justice, Common Cause and Commonwealth Human Rights Initiative. So this is the data which shows on justice delivery. Then this is railway vendor faces flak for recruitment aid ad on caste lines. So IRCTC reprimands this firm after backlash on social media. It is the Indian Railway Catering and Tourism Corporation, which had given an ad by this railway vendor ticked off by the IRCTC also, which alluded to caste preferences in recruitment. So it was this railway vendor, Vrindavan Food Products. It sought 100 male candidates for 3 posts, and train catering manager, base kitchen manager and store manager. In the recruitment ad, it said candidates should belong to Agrawal Vaish community and have a good family background, besides educational qualification of 10+2. So such criteria, caste-based criteria, has resulted in backlash. Then this is Bulbul likely to bring heavy rain in Odisha. So this is cyclonic storm Bulbul over east central Bay of Bengal, which may skip Odisha coast, but the state government has taken no chance and has kept its coastal districts prepared for the storm. And here you have family alleges starvation death in Jharkhand. So a family in Jharkhand's Girith district has alleged that one of its members died of starvation. But the state's food and civil supplies minister said that these are false claims, and the minister said that the perfectly laid out protocol to prevent death due to starvation is in place in Jharkhand. He says that there is a protocol to give ration under Annapurna Yojana to the needy even if they don't have ration cards. Then there are grain banks, and 10,000 is given to mukhyas who can be approached for assistance. And here you have Kerala on its way to achieve 100% internet penetration. So it has the second highest coverage as such too. And here you can see the internet penetration shown here in rural and urban areas and total penetration. You can see it is free optic Kerala free fiber optic network project, which would provide internet to every household in the state. So here you can see Himachal Pradesh, it has good internet coverage. So it is a report titled India Internet 2019, which shows state's penetration rate as such. So then Delhi NCR has 69% penetration, internet penetration. And Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Delhi have highest proportion of female internet users. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Real Estate Shelter. So this is regarding the alternative investment fund which was announced by the central government. It says it could help revive the stressed sector, the real estate sector. So this is an editorial on that. We discussed this in front page news yesterday. And this is junking fast food. So this was also news day before, in which FSSAI has notified draft regulation for prohibiting sale and advertisement of food rich in fat, sugar and salt to school children. So it says enforcement is key in preventing school children from accessing unhealthy food. The lead article, the theory of the Islamic State. So this talks of Islamic State. So it says this will be defeated only when its ideology is overcome in a region free of interventions. So it's a tall ask for the moment. And below you have unwriting history, creating myths. So it is said accounts from the past suggest that Sardar Patel played a key role in incorporation of Article 370 in the Constitution. So this aspect is highlighted in this article. On the op-ed page, you have, should online political advertising be regulated? So, on Fridays, you have this parlay coverage. So, this is a question on which views, counter views are given. So, micro-targeting could have potentially damaging results in the context of political advertising. So, we had seen how Twitter has said that it will no longer carry political advertisements. So, this is in that context. And this is changing the status quo. So Home Ministry's move to merge Assam Rifles with ITBP. It is said to be a step in the right direction. So Indo-Tibetan Border Police and Assam Rifles will be merged. So this has been proposed by Ministry of Home Affairs. So this is very important. On page 12, you have 3 years since demonetization, cash is back. So also digital payment, especially on UPI platform, have seen a robust growth, but cash is back in the economy and cash is still the king. So here you can see the growth in cash is shown, currency with public, how it has increased. On page 13, you have center to revoke Tasir's OCI card. So he tried to conceal information is what the union government has said, that his father was of Pakistani origin. So his overseas citizen of India card has been revoked, but actually it is said this is an action being taken because of his an article critical of Modi in a US magazine. And here you have Kartarpur pilgrims need passports, OCI cards. So now ministry has clarified that Pakistan army contradicts Imran's statement waiving passport requirement, and now they say there will be passport OCI card required. But then there's no harm in having that as an essential while visiting the Kartarpur shrine. And this is government clears Justice Qureshi's appointment. So he'll head the Tripura High Court. Supreme Court Collegium had recommended his name, and even when it was sent back for consideration, it was recommended again. And now finally the appointment has taken place. On international page, you have Iran resumes uranium enrichment at Fordow plant. So this marks Iran's fourth step away from the 2015 nuclear agreement. Uranium enrichment has started at other establishment. You can see this is in Natanz uranium enrichment facility. The centrifuge machines are shown here. So all this has taken place because USA opted out of the Iran nuclear deal. And here you have ex-Twitter employee spied for Saudi Arabia, alleges US. So with respect to social media platforms like Twitter, two former employees of Twitter and a third man from Saudi Arabia face US charges of spying for Saudi by digging up private user data and giving it to Saudi officials in exchange for payment. And here also you have documents show how Facebook harnessed user data. So partners like Amazon got special access to user data from Facebook. So such are the allegations being made, lawsuits filed. And this is border with Nepal not altered. So India has said that new map of the country did not revise anything as far as border with Nepal is concerned. So this response came after Nepal's foreign ministry complained that the map depicted Nepali territory of Kalapani as part of Indian state of Uttarakhand. On business page you have IRDAI cracks down on Reliance Health. So regulator for insurance regulator and development authority of India, it has directed Reliance Health Insurance Company to stop selling new policies. So you know, there are solvency worries with respect to the entity. So this is the detail given here. And this is government mulling changes to laws to address inter-regulatory issues. So, Finance Ministry has discussed economy related issue at FSDC meeting, that is Financial Stability and Development Council. So, there are various regulatory bodies and their work overlaps. We have seen this issue quite often. So, this is in that context. So, this is very, very important from exam perspective. Then, on the last page you have Eat Lancet diet too costly for 1.58 billion people. So researchers say that $2.84 per day meal expenses would exceed daily per capita income in many low income nations. So this is a diet meant to improve both human and planetary health, but it is unaffordable for at least 1.58 billion people, mostly in sub-Saharan Africa and South Asia. So this is what the study shows. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.